Okay, so then let's start now talking about chapter 14, which is about heat. So what is heat? Well, we know very well that if we have two objects that are at different temperature, if we put them in contact, we know that heat will flow from the hot object to the cold one. Yeah? And this process, this flow, will remain until the temperature of both objects become the same. Right? So when the temperature of both objects becomes equal, we say that this whole system, which involves the two objects, reached thermal equilibrium. So we see a connection there between heat and temperature, but these are two very different concepts. Let's see, how do we understand each one? Temperature, as we saw in chapter 13, is a measure of the average kinetic energy of the molecules. Right, so if we have a hot recipient, so if this recipient is hot, we know that the molecules here have high kinetic energy. This other recipient, which is colder, we know that cold, low temperature means that the molecules here have low kinetic energy. Okay, so this is the idea of temperature. Once we put these two recipients, these two objects in contact, what will happen microscopically? Well, these hot molecules will collide with this cold, will collide with the cold molecules, and so the hot will transfer part of its kinetic energy to the to the molecules that have low kinetic energy. And so through this collision, we will reach a point where the average kinetic energy of both recipients become the same, when then the temperature of both recipients become the same. Okay, so difference in temperature allows for this flow of heat, which is nothing else than this collision through between this molecules, and so this transfer of kinetic energy from the one that has higher kinetic energy to the ones that have lower kinetic energy. All right, so as we see, what is heat? Heat is just this transfer of energy, the transfer of kinetic energy from high temperature, from the object that is at high temperature to the object that is at low temperature. Well, when people started studying this, they didn't really know. They didn't have this microscopic picture, so they didn't really know what was going on. They just noticed that something was being transferred from hot to cold, and they thought this was a real substance, a real material, which they then called caloric. Nowadays we know it's energy, but at that time people didn't know. They thought it was a real material, and that's why one of the units that we use to talk about heat is the famous calorie. Indicated with this CAL. So what is one calorie? What is the definition of one calorie which came from those early studies? One calorie is the amount of heat that we need to raise the temperature of 1 gram of water by 1 degree Celsius. Okay? When we read the labels of food that we buy, one of the items there is the amount of calories, but what is really written is kilocalories. Okay, so if you read the labels, you will see usually either this symbol, and then you know it's kilocalories, or sometimes you see a CAL like that, but with capital C. These two means the same thing, means kilocalorie. In other words, these two means 1,000 calories. Okay, so what is then 1 kilocalorie, which we can also indicate with this capital C, is the heat that is necessary to raise the temperature 1 kilogram of water by 1 degree Celsius. Now 1 kilogram in this case. Okay, let's go for the next slide. How did people finally figure out the heat was just energy? Well, there was a lot of experiments going on, a lot of many research going on, especially in the 1800s, about heat. And why is that? Well, 1800s is the period of the Industrial Revolution, is the period where people are trying to burn things, burn wood, burn coal to get work done, and to make their machines do whatever they want, to make cars move, to make trains move. Okay, so there is a lot of research about heat. One of these experiments is the one done by Joule. And what did he do? It's a smart experiment. He had this big recipient filled with water, and inside this recipient he had this pellet. Okay? Attached here to these pellets we have this rope connected holding this weight. As we let this weight fall, so this weight will be losing gravitational potential energy. As this weight loses gravitational potential energy, this gravitational potential energy is transferred to motion. It makes these pellets move. So the gravitational potential energy becomes kinetic energy. And what he noticed by putting a thermometer here is that the temperature of the water inside raised. So then he made this connection. Well, it's all what is going on here, just a transfer of energy from potential, gravitational potential, into kinetic energy of the pellet, and which is then raising the temperature of the water. So it's raising the kinetic energy of the molecules in the water. Okay? So that's one of the experiments that convinced people, made people understand that heat is just energy being transferred. We know that the unit for energy in the international system is joule. How do we connect joule with this unit that we are calling calories? Well, this is the conversion. One calorie is 4.186 joule. And if you talk about kilocalorie, then be careful, we'll be talking about kilojoule. Okay, so let's solve here a very simple little problem. We have a woman who is 60 kilograms, so let me put this information here for us. We have this woman who is, the mass of this woman is 60 kilograms. We want to know how much, what would be the total height that she would have to climb to compensate for 500 calories that she ate. Well, careful here, this calorie is with capital. So what she ate, the amount of energy that she consumed, is 500 kilocalories, which we can transform to joules. 500 kilocalories, so 10 to 3. Each calorie, as we said, is 4.18 6 joules, so multiply this for 4.186 and you get this whole amount in joules. Okay, so this is what she ate. We want to know how much, what would be the total height that she would need to climb to compensate for this amount of energy that she consumed. Okay, so what we want to know is the potential energy, what is the amount of potential energy, gravitational potential energy, that is equivalent to this amount of energy consumed. In other words, we want the potential energy, which we know is mgh. Well, we are talking about here this change of gravitational potential energy. So mgh, we want this to be equal to this number that you obtained here. Well, so what we have to put here, mass is 60 kilogram, g 9.8, the height that we are trying to obtain, and this number that you computed with your calculator. So be careful here, I'm using joules as the energy, because here I'm using kilograms, here I'm using meters per second squared, so I'm using the international system. If you put all this in your calculator, you should obtain that this height is 3,600 meters. Okay, so this is the first two slides. Let's see just one more slide about concepts. So we already discuss two important concepts. We talked about temperature. As we said, the temperature of a gas is just a measure of the average kinetic energy of the molecules. We said the heat. Heat is the energy that is transferred from one object to the other when we have a difference in temperature. And let's introduce one more concept, which is this one, internal energy. What is it that we are going to call internal energy? It's the total energy of all the molecules in the object. No? So each molecule has its own kinetic energy. Let's sum this kinetic energy for all of the different molecules. That's what we call internal energy. Okay? If we are thinking about an ideal gas, you know, the ideal gas that we discussed in chapter 13, what would be its internal energy? We are going to denote internal energy with this letter U. So what would be this internal energy? N is the number of all the atoms that we have, no? All the atoms of this ideal gas. So all the atoms multiplied by the average kinetic energy of each one. That's going to be our internal energy. So let me write this here. What is the internal energy for this ideal gas? The internal energy is N, the number of all the atoms that we have, multiplied by its average kinetic energy. So 1/2 of M and this average kinetic speed. So this gives us the average kinetic energy. Okay, we also learned in chapter 13 that when we have an ideal gas, this average kinetic energy is related to the temperature, and it's related to the temperature in this way, 3/2 of K, K here is Boltzmann constant, T, T is the temperature. So another way for us to write this internal energy is equal to N, K, 3/2 of the temperature. Okay, that's another way to write what is the internal energy of an atomic gas, an ideal atomic gas. So N is the total number of atoms, K is Boltzmann constant. Remember also in chapter 13, we said that this combination can also be written as little n, which is the number of moles, and R. R is this constant that we also saw in chapter 13 is the universal gas constant. Okay, so all that to say that our internal energy can also be written as 3/2 of N number of moles, R, this universal gas constant, multiplied by T, the temperature. This equation here, which is what you're seeing here, is the equation that is valid for an ideal gas. It's not what we have for real gases. But don't worry, we are only going to be studying ideal gases. And this is an equation that we are introducing here in chapter 14, but we are only going to use it in chapter 15. Okay, so these three slides give us the beginning of chapter 14. We are now going to move to other slides where we talk about equations that describe the transfer of energy due to difference in temperature, the flow of heat. Okay, so this is the end here. I'm going to stop and then start a new video for the next slide.